Now, if the stars and or constellations are close enough to North Celestial Pole, they are always visible, and those stars and constellations are called circumpolar stars. And let me explain. This diagram illustrates what we see in the northern hemisphere. So here is Polaris, which marks the location of North Celestial Pole. So that's the point on celestial sphere directly above the Earth's North Pole. And as you can see, the stars in these constellations move in the counterclockwise direction as observed by us in the northern hemisphere. So these stars that make up this is not really the true Ursa Major, this is just Big Dipper, part of Ursa Major, that make up the Big Dipper and Little Dipper, they are constantly visible, right? Because they are close enough to the North Celestial Pole. They never rise or set above or below the horizon. Other examples are these ones, Cassiopeia, that has the shape of the letter W. It's named after an Egyptian princess. There is another one, Perseus, Cepheus, and so on. Okay, so all the stars that are part of these constellations or asterisms are close enough to the North Celestial Pole so that they are always visible. Such stars are called circumpolar stars. They never rise or set above or below the horizon here.